In this video, I will show you how to pick an order completely manually using the admin interface. We encourage you to use scanning, but this is a topic for another video. So here I'm met with the order list, and typically these are orders are coming from some other system, such as a web shop. You could also create orders manually, but that is also a topic for a different video. We're going to pick two orders, the first ones here, and the first order has just one order row, and we're going to pick 8 shorts. And in the second one, we have 2 order rows, so we're going to pick shorts and t-shirts on that order. Now you see here that you can select them. We see that both of these orders are pickable and it says OK, and this means that we have goods in stock. Otherwise, it would say not OK or pre-O and non-pre-O, depending on which order was first, if the stock was limited and only enough for one order. You have some statuses here in this column. Open released will typically be what you start with, and then in our case we will also show allocated and picked, and then sent and collected, or only collected in this video when you're done processing the orders. We're going to start with the first one, and here we're going to let the system decide where we're going to pick the stock, and we do that with pressing the allocate button. Now, then goods is locked from certain position in the system, and namely, we're using per default the first in, first out principle. So whatever came in stock first for these, I think it was t-shirts, right? Shorts, sorry. So we click allocate, and then we see that the status of the order is changed, and now the goods is locked from in the warehouse, and you can no longer make changes to this order from the web shop, for example. And then in the first option, we're going to press pick, and that means that the stock is subtracted from the location in the warehouse, and you'll also get a pick list per default here. So click pick, and then here's the pick list, and it says where we're going to go to, what location, HA0401, and we're going to pick this article number and 8 of those. So that's the first option. And the second option, so we uncheck this order, and the second option has 2 order rows, so we have it selected, and then we're going to press out, and this is going to let us choose the goods that we want to pick from where, what location, completely manually. So first here you see an order row. We're going to pick 3 shorts, and if we scroll down we can see that the shorts are located in these 2 locations. So for whatever reason I might want to take 1 from the first location, and then let's say I want to take 2 from the second location, and you see here that now we have 1 out of 3, and now it automatically goes to the next order row, the t-shirts here, and here I can take all 6 of them from the first location. Press pick. So now I can create picked here, and you'll see that the status of the order has changed. You can also print out the delivery note of an order, and you do that with the order selected, and you click delivery note, and then you get a PDF, and this is probably what you want to put in the package when you send it to your customer. But let's say you have done something wrong with the order, so still with status picked, you can change it. So let's expand here, and you can simply just delete one of these. Let's say you didn't want the t-shirts to be picked from this location, and then you can press delete here. And with the order selected, you can once again click the out button. And here we have the first order row, which are the shorts. They were fine. And the second order row, let's say you want to pick your items from this one instead. You can just go here and click pick. And now you can go back to your order list here, and you will see that the t-shirts are picked from a different location here. All right, so the final steps of processing an order could be that you either want to just have another status here, not picked, but collected. So we can do that for the first order. Click collected, and then you'll see that the status has changed. And then we also have a send button, and this is suitable if you have an integration to a transport administration system and you press that button, you get a printing label, and then put that on top of the package and send it away. But that's also a topic for another video. So to summarize, you can pick an order by first pressing allocate and then pick, and you'll get a pick list, or you can select an order and click out to choose what goods you want to pick from the warehouse manually. And then you also have this delivery note, and picking list will probably be quite useful items to always put on the order. That's it for this video. Thank you very much.